Hi, Dalton. It's Joe, and obviously, and I've known you for 3 years now, and I have to admit you are one of the closest friends I have, and you are one of the only friends that I have. And even though that we are not going to see each other very often anymore, probably never, I just hope that you don't change for the bad, and I hope that you remember me, and I will always remember you.
So, don't turn into a private school snob.
Don't do that.
Or bad things will happen to you, I promise. I guarantee it.
And remember that we're always going to be cooler than you.
Sorry, pal. And,
yeah,
alright, your best friend. Yeah.
We have goodbye.
Bye.
We love you. Baby.
Hey Dalton, I'm gonna miss you. Here's some advice. Don't drop out of school and don't be a bully. And if you do get bullied, just roll your eyes and walk away. Bye.
Hey Dalton, I'll miss you. I love you. You're funny. And don't be afraid to wear pink. And be nice to girls.
Little day, be a big rock star. Eat your fruits and vegetables. And have a good day every day. Hi, President Day. I hope you have a good graduation. Bye.
Neo Presidente, Big Boy Dalton. You're going out there into the big, wide world. But you're all set. So, my only advice for you is be yourself always, because yourself is really cool, as you've been told many times. And have fun. And don't do anything that Jesse hasn't already done, which is almost everything, so you're pretty much good. And we'll miss you a lot. And you better come back and see us little people back here on the island.
Hi, Dalton. How are you? I just want to wish you the best in your future, but I also want to give you some advice, and that would be to always call your mother and drive on the right and keep a smile on your face and a song in your heart. There you go.
Hey, big step. It's like going to college for you. You're taking the move early. I certainly hope the food is good. If it's not, complain to mom and you'll get lots of care packages. That's my advice. Enjoy.
Don't marry a bad guy or a pirate. And not anybody's not nice. And but marry whoever you want to marry.
El Presidente, don't get arrested.
Wow.
Say.
Wow.
You say uh-oh.
Very few people who know you as well as I do. You may annoy me a lot of the times by, well, a lot I can't explain in school. But you also help me get through tough times, and you help me with, I was gonna say homework, but you don't help me with homework. But you help me with a lot of things, and you're very fun and funny. I'm now going to name the top 5 memories I think are the best. So, we are playing a game that involves hitting each other. And you probably don't know what the game would be by hitting each other, but yet again, I can't explain it in school. And so, I won the game, and I was about to hit you. And then all of a sudden, you scream, self-defense, and you start kicking and pushing me away from you. In self-defense, even though it's just a game. When I was 3 years old, my mom was blowing bubbles. Me and you were popping them. For some reason, I decided to pull you down on the ground. So I did it, but instead of landing on the ground, you landed on top of me. And you broke my collarbone. Yeah, that wasn't fun. At all. Number 3. when you were obsessed with shuffling because you did a really good dance at the IIE. So you're still obsessed with shuffling about 2 to 3 months later. So you decide to make Jesse do a video of you shuffling around the school.
Cut to the video.
Every day I'm shuffling.
He won't stop shuffling.
Now we know why you can be very annoying sometimes. And I'm still nervous about going on a black diamond. This is during skiing, just so you know. You, Wolfie, and Orion actually got me to go down a black diamond. I'm going to put quotes around it because it wasn't that hard. I was edging my way down, you know, going very slowly. To make me feel better, you climbed halfway up the trail just to, like, get me to come down. And finally I got down and you were halfway up the trail. Last but not least, dinner for Schmucks. You, Jesse, Anne, and me were all at the store deciding for a movie. The movie, as you chose, was Dinner for Schmucks. While we were watching it, Jesse and Anne kept raising their voices to talk over inappropriate stuff. And eventually it got to the point that it was so inappropriate that we had to turn the movie off. Now you will always be known for the person who chose Dinner for Schmucks and ruined our lives. I will miss you, and you'll be the best brother ever I've ever had, even though you're the only one. One last word of advice. Don't ever watch Dinner for Schmucks again, even with your friends. Okay, I hope you have a good time at boarding school.
Oh, Dalton, I don't know what to say. I was there when you were born. I drove the truck home that took you home at 2 a.m. in the morning with your mom. And boy, we were both scared. And your first time on Monhegan, you sat on this porch and you pointed and said light. And then you said moon. And then you waved at all the trucks, and all the trucks waved at you and honked, and they all knew you and you loved it.
One memory I have of you that is still in my mind, and I probably tell you every time I see you, which is the one time me, you, Gabe, Quinn, and Nate were coming back from school one day, and there was a giant hole, I think my uncle had dug, for like some sewage line, meadow line, I don't know what it was for, but it was half filled with water, and I said, well, do you want to test the water? And Dawn, you raised your hand, and then jumped. Next thing I knew, you were just right in the water, and the ice broke, and then Gabe had to haul you out because I was just laughing too hard. And then I just remember you walking down the road as a frozen popsicle.
Hi Dalton, congratulations on your graduation from 8th grade. I just wanted to share a memory I had of you from when you first arrived to the island, when you were first moving here. And you were 6 years old and it was Cole's birthday and you came over with the whole family at first, but then you wanted to stay, and everyone else left, like Angela and Quinn and Kathy, they all took off, and you just sat there with all the other adults, and you just really made an impression, because you were very polite, and you interacted with everyone as if you just fit right in. And I think you're just going to do that continuously through your life. You're going to just fit right in, and you're a nice man, and you're going to be really successful.
So I've been thinking about you and me at the Monhegan School, and you, me, and Schooner have been at the Monhegan School for 8 years. We have been together all 8 years. Schooner was 4 when you started. We've been through 2 teachers, 3 superintendents, 4 other ed techs. We've been through 8 kickballs. Can you believe that? Kickball started your first year. Remember hobnob walks? I think we're still having those when you were here. Chet's camp. Remember the puke helmet? Do you remember reading Harry Potter? We read the Harry Potter books. Do you remember the robotics climate project? And we couldn't get in because the boat canceled. And then the robotics canceled. And then we were stuck in shore with Angela, so we went Christmas shopping for like 4 days. Okay. Remember radioactive blue flaming ninja kitties? Remember the year of printmaking? We were so sick of printmaking. We were printmaking bags, shirts. We had printmaking class. Remember the year of Wolfie's Red Sox art? Everything he did was Red Sox. Remember the year of Quinn's Dragon art, which is this year. Remember, oh, Livin' La Vida Loca. Remember that? She will wear you out. Remember you as Linus in the Charlie Brown Christmas. Remember Haitian night, Italian night. Remember the talent show. Remember Quebec City school trip. Remember United States of Christmas. Hello down there. Remember, what's a pretty fire? I got Quinn cracking up.
I have a memory I didn't get to share, and it's my first memory of you after I had accepted the job in Hegan, and I had just moved out at the end of August. And you had just gotten back with Quinn from Alaska, and we were up at the ball field playing kickball because it was Wyatt's birthday. And I was playing first base, and you were on the opposite team, so you had run to first base. And I was like, good job, Dalton. And I was asking you all these questions about how your summer was and if you're excited for school. You were super cute and polite and answering everything, and then kind of quiet for a second. And then you turned to me and you said, excuse me, but am I supposed to know who you are? Always just cracks me up because, like it or not, you have definitely gotten to know me and know who I am. Good and bad and ugly. You've seen me in some really good days and probably some pretty grumpy days, so sorry about that. And vice versa, I've seen you at your best and then I've seen you at some middle school grumpy worst. So, but I wouldn't change it for anything.
Dalton, I just love you. I remember you, you know, when you're just a little Dalton and you first discovered whoopie pies at the novelty. And you know, you've really got a place in my heart, buddy. You really do.
Okay, so Margaret and I were talking about some different advice that maybe she might give you, but I'm going to tell you about it. Number one would be always bring a snack so you don't get grumpy, because if you don't have a snack, you might be grumpy. Number two, even though you might not be the one who does this, it's important to remember to put the seat down on the toilet, because girls don't like it when the seat's on. And the other advice, I think, is enjoy life and jump in puddles.
Yeah.
All right, see ya.
Alton, how's it going? I know I'm probably not going to be here for graduation, so I just wanted to give you some words of advice. So the main thing, words of advice I have is, like, just try everything. Like, that's the way you meet people. Like, I know I tried baseball, didn't really like it, but this year I, like, tried ultimate frisbee and had a blast.
So, Dalton, advice for high school. I've never been to high school, but my advice would be yourself. If there's anyone bugging you, just don't worry about them.
I'm not going to give you any advice because you're not going to use it anyway. You're going to make your own mistakes, and that's the best advice, is just know that you're going to make mistakes. Learn from those mistakes. Nobody's perfect. Have fun. Whatever you do, enjoy life. Think of one positive thing every day and start the day that way. Think of one positive aspect of yourself that you know you have. Carry that with you every day and you'll be great. Good luck, Dalton.
Hi, Dalton. This is your big day. You're graduating, going to high school, and I've got a couple words of wisdom for you. And I know you're expecting it in Polish. Well, but that's not gonna happen. I did it for Wolfie and I did it for Gabe. It's just so predictable. So, sorry, but for you, it's all English so you can understand what I have to say to you. Bądź dobrym uczniem. Pilnie się ucz i studiuj. Nie ganiaj za dziewczynami, bo jeszcze za młody jesteś na to, chociaż wyglądasz na dobrze wyrosłego chłopa. Pamiętaj dzwonić do mamusi, bo mama będzie się bardzo martwić o ciebie. No i oczywiście wszystkie nowe znajomości, jakie zawiążesz, będą na pewno na całe życie. Więc enjoy yourself in Putney!
Here's my advice. Wait till you're older to shave your head. You might have some regrets.
Dalton, advice. Okay, I have to try to remember all of it. First one is be careful what you rent from Redbox.
second piece of advice is be nice to Quinn, because I love him, and you do too. Even if sometimes you pretend like you don't. And third one, don't be afraid to do a flash mob. And fourth one is...
Always have dogs.
Always have dogs. Thank you, Quinn. And...
Don't get anyone pregnant.
Would you like to add that in?
Yeah, don't get anyone pregnant too early.
Too early. Okay, so sixth one is always put your periods and your commas inside your quotation marks, unless you're citing a reference, and then it goes at the end of the sentence. And seventh one is you're the best.
Hey Dalton, I have no advice for you except to just be your wonderful self. And we're going to miss you a lot around here, so come back often. Stay as open to everybody and as in touch with yourself as you always are. You're about the most centered person I know. Perfect. I love you.
My advice to you is, if you can't get what you want, bark really loud. A bit of advice for you, Dalton, if you know you graduate and all that and you move back to the island, if you get any kinds of pets like chickens or dogs or anything, don't let them in Barbara Stanley's yard, okay? If you don't, you'll be all set. That's it.
Dalton, I'm so excited for you. You're finished here on Monhegan and you're going out into the world, into America, and I just want to give you one tip. Don't play in traffic.
Hi, Dalton. I'm not going to talk bacon with you because I know everybody else is going to do that. And I'm not going to give you any packing advice because I seem to recollect you're really, really good in that department. So, two quick things. One, don't ever eat egg salad in public. And last thing, someday you might meet somebody, they might feel a little superior to you, they might try and put you down. Just hold your own, look them in the eye and say, have you ever had a drink named after you at the Black Duck?
Hey Dalton, well this is it, you know, your transition to the next phase of your life, and I just wish you all the best, and all I can tell you is to enjoy every day and do what makes you happy, what really makes you feel full and happy and joyful, and you'll have a great life.
Remember what Victor always says, if it seems a bit much and you miss your island, keep your chins up.
When you go off to school, take your passion with you and have lots of fun in life. Okay? Bye-bye. Oh, and what else was it, Brenda, you want to say? Remember? He wants you to know that you should bring some toys with you. Okay, take care.
I have three pieces of advice to get you through high school, but I can't tell them to you on film. Your mom would kill me.
Did want to give you some advice. Okay. First of all, just word to the wise. If you... having some girl problems, don't put it on Facebook. And I guess my other advice is just don't forget us and know that we love you and I love you and I'm always here for you. And if you ever, you know, are stranded in the middle of the night and you're too scared to call your mom, call me.
Well, Dalton, we hear you leaving and we're sorry to see you go. We're going to miss you very much. Be a good boy. Call your mother regularly. Don't forget. That's it.
Hi, Dalton. I was thinking about you and all the other kids. I always tell them, oh, be nice to women and, you know, be honest and work hard. But you already do all that stuff because you're a totally awesome kid. So I think you need to start being the one giving advice. Thanks.
Hey, Dalton. We just wanted to tell you that we are going to miss you when you head off, and mostly we're going to miss, let's see, what were we going to miss? Remember? I think your hair. I've noticed that there's been a lot of different hairdos over time, so I hope you'll bring back another new one when you visit. No colors, please. Okay, you're an artist. So we're also going to miss your artwork very much every time we walk into school. We love to see your artwork, and so we hope you'll send us some of it. And mostly we're going to miss your smile, because every time we walk down the road and we see Dalton, he smiles and he has a very nice, kind, polite manner.
Hi, Dalton. I
Really will miss you. I'll miss the music, and it really sometimes surprised me when you played games. And I like to see the puzzles done. Bye, I will really miss you, Dalton.
And I'm gonna really miss you teasing me, Pitch. No. I also sometimes don't like. I'm gonna miss how you always like, no, I didn't cheat at this game, I didn't do that, I'm not a cheater. And you take things a little bit too seriously sometimes. And I'm gonna just miss you being around me.
Hi Dalton, Millie and I want to say good luck and also congratulations. And Dalton, it has been fantastic to come to know you for all these many years, and I appreciate all of your enthusiasm and your wisdom for our middle school retreats and all that you've done in the community. You'll have a great time at Putney, and I noticed that you're choosing a school where you know at least one other girl, and you'll know another one, Emma, I told you about her, and so you know two girls at Putney, and good choice. So I wish you well, it's been great to come to know you, I want to hear all about your high school experience, and good luck, I miss you, we love you, have a great time, bye.
Crispy, crunchy, salty and smoky. Sizzling goodness crackles in the black pan. Never say no to bacon. Although you should, if you can, make sure that it's humanely raised and organic. Have fun at school.
Love you, Dalton. Bye-bye.
Hi, Dalton. Congratulations on graduating. You finally made it. And good luck in high school.
Congratulations, Dalton. Hope everything goes well on the way to school. Watch out for all the young ladies. I know what you're going to be busy doing all the time.
So good luck at Putney. You know how close that is to where we live in the winter? Very close. You might be having lunch with us. Because, yeah, you got good things coming for you.
Love you. See you in Vermont.
Bye. Good luck, Dalton.
Hey, Dalton. I just want to wish you good luck. I know you'll do great. You're an intelligent, fine young man. You have great parents, and I know you'll do great. Remember to get as involved as you can and make as many friends as you can. I know you will. Enjoy it. It'll be the best years of your life, so they say, I think. So, right on, man.
Love you so much. Good luck. See you soon.
Dalton, you're headed off to high school. That is so much fun. You're going to what? Putnam? Putney? Passover? What? I can't remember. Where are you going again? Well, wherever you go, I know you're going to have a good time, and I know that you'll meet lots of girls, and you will study hard, right? Okay. Take care. Love you.
Hello, Dalton. This message is from Susan and Victor. We wish you well as you journey forth into the world. And I just wanted to say that we think you're a fine fellow, very intelligent, and creative, great artist, and I think caring, because I think you're very kind to especially younger persons, and sensitive. So have a great time out there, have a wonderful time in high school.
You are an amazing person, Dalton. I am so proud of you. So go, have a great time. We're all behind you. I promise I will bake you cookies and send them, and bacon. I will send you bacon. I love you, Dalton. That's it.
You've done a great job. We're going to miss you, but I know you'll do well.
I'm just really honored that I get to look back, you know, when I'm an old gray-haired lady and thinking about my teaching career and think of you. I was one of my first students. Probably you and Quinn will be the students I've had the longest and always will hold close to my heart. You're like my family. And I hope that you always remember me. And just, I love all the memories we have together. I think we're really lucky that we got to have each other the last 5 years. And I'm really proud to be your teacher. So I love you. And I'll probably start crying. So just wait for my speech, because I'm going to be a bloody mess. Okay, bye.
All right, Dalton. I've spent the last 3 years trying to warp your mind as much as possible. I don't really know what else to say. Good luck.
It's been exciting to see you grow up, and I'm very excited for your next year. And good luck. I love you. Your grandma.
Hey, Dalton. It's just me saying I hope you have a great time at high school. Good luck.
Hi, Dalton. I just wanted to say that I tried to do this video before, and I tried to hide behind a puppet because I thought I was going to cry, and I did cry. But I thought it was kind of... I wasn't being brave enough by hiding behind a puppet. So here I am, and I just wanted to say that, of course, the advice will keep flowing from me because I'm your mom, and I'm not going to say goodbye to you quite yet. But I am very honored to be your mom, and so very proud of who you are and who you've come to be. And that I'm going to be here for you, whatever you need, except for money, because you know we don't have any money, so don't come home for money. But if you need a hug or you need, I don't know, advice, or support, we're gonna be here for you. And we love you. I love you very much. And you are going to do great at Putney and beyond. And I love you.